What is up, good rocking morning. Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Flippinstoop. I hope you guys are getting your day started, rocking it out, and said your gratitudes, started your morning off right, and push forward, right? I'm gonna make this video around the idea of it's possible for anybody, and it don't matter what you're doing. I don't care. I mean, maybe it's not possible for me to become a professional football player right now because I'm 41 years young and I'm competing with people that are half my age. Not even, right? So that's probably not gonna be possible. But whatever your goals, whatever your expectations are in life, on eBay, in the gym, in your relationships, financially, relationship-wise, whatever they are, they're attainable. Good morning, John. Thanks for watching, brother. They're attainable. However, if you're unhappy with something in life, I'm overcoming a few different things in life right now, and I will expose them all within a couple of weeks. I've overcome a lot of addictions and things of that nature in my past, but there has been a couple things I've struggled with, and I'm working the kinks out on that right now, and anything's possible, don't matter what age you are. I just wanted to say that before I jumped into the gym. I don't have a lengthy video. I wanted to drop that though, because I don't know who needs to hear that, but sometimes that's all we need to hear is you're perfectly capable of doing it. However, if you want different results than you've been getting for the past 2 years, for the past 5 years, for the past 2 months, for the past 6 months, the only way to get different results is to do something different. Right? Become a different person. Like, I was just listening to something earlier this morning. They were going over how selfish people are in relationships. And I can attend to that. I have been myself, right? Where by not being your best you, you're being selfish to the people you are with, right? Because you're not giving a person the best of what you're capable of, which is actually being selfish to the, and I'm literally going through this right now with my own beautiful significant other. I have not been giving her my 1000% best version, 2.0, 3.0, 4.0, whatever you want to call it, a Flippinstoop. I have not gave her that. I have not gave her time that she deserves. I haven't been sensitive enough in certain aspects of her relationship, right? So that's one of the few topics I'm working on, and I will overcome, and I will achieve, and I will become the best version of me. Matter of fact, there'll be a lot of different things going on the channel due to that. I haven't been fair to you. Here's another thing. I haven't been even fair to my subscribers, right? You guys think, what are you talking about? Because you guys, if I'm not being the best me, you're not getting the best video quality that I can do. I can do better video quality. I have more life experiences I can share. I have more eBay experiences I can share. I have more knowledge on eBay that I don't talk a lot about because I don't find it that relevant to me, but it could be to somebody else. There's a lot of areas in my life where I'm not being my 100% full potential, right? So we all have areas in our life we can improve when we can actually be humble enough and admit that we can see them, start making working towards them. I made leaps and bounds in my life. I did 10 years in prison. I was a drug addict junkie for 20, 25 years. Smoked cigarettes for another 25, maybe even 30. Well, I'm 41. Yeah, I did start smoking cigarettes right around 11, 12 years old, right? Now, maybe not every single day, all day, but I did start experimenting with them when I was 10 or 11 years old. So I've overcame a lot, but I'm not perfect. I don't want anybody in this group to ever think that my life's a fucking, perfect pitch and I got everything figured out. I don't. I have a lot of room for growth. And I was feeling guilty yesterday because I'm not bringing the best version of myself to the rest of the people. This is how we got to think. I'm not telling you how you got to think. This is how I got to think. I'm actually being a selfish person. Because I'm not bringing my best self. But the crazy part is, this is going to sound like it contradicts itself, right? To be the best version of yourself, you got to be selfish. Listen, that sounds like it totally contradicts itself, but it does not. Listen very closely. To be the best version of you, you have to be selfish enough to work on yourself, which means If you're one of them people that'll drop everything on a dime and do everything for everybody, and I'm not saying that's a bad attribute, but you do have to put some of yours, you have to do some things for yourself to become a better version of you. I talked about it the other day. And that takes, you got to be a bit selfish, right? Like, okay, it don't have to be, hey, 24 hours a day, I'm going to be selfish. You know what I mean? It could be, hey, from 6 o'clock in the morning till 10 o'clock in the morning, that's my time, right? And I don't break on that. I'm not going to bend on that. And it can be as simple as that. And then the rest of the day, you got me for whatever else, right? You have to be selfish for yourself in order to not be selfish for others. That sounds crazy, right? When I say them words, it sounds like, okay, he's contradicting himself. He sounds like a hypocrite. Everything else under the sun, but it's in all actuality, it's facts, right? So number one is you got to be selfish for yourself so you can be the best version of yourself, right? Because if you're not being the best version of yourself, you're screwing the people around you. They're not seeing the best quality you can give. Look, and I know we all in life you might be doing great, you might be doing good, but we all could do better. And it could be as something as simple as feeling more hydrated so you have more energy with your grandkids. It could be something that simple, right? I'm not talking about, hey, let's move mountains. I will never talk about that during eBay, and I'll never talk about that in life experiences. Don't ever think if your life is in shambles or it's a mess or whatever, that you got to fix everything at once, because it'll never work for you that way. You got to pick one thing and focus on that. Example, I was not getting my gym out of the way before the rest of my day started. I'm breaking that cycle. I realized I wasn't being the best version of myself to my significant other, to you, all you in the channel, to all the people, to people you don't even know. If you're not at your best, you know, do you know how much putting a smile on somebody's face at a gas station can do for their life? Right? You don't know what that person's going through. You don't know what kind of morning they just had. You don't know if they just got their ass beat. Like, you don't know what's going on, right? You don't know if they lost a loved one. If you're not being the best version of you, you're probably not going to put a smile on that person's face at the gas station, right? Which is being selfish, right? So I'm working big time on not being as selfish. There's good selfishness and there's bad selfishness. You don't want the bad selfishness. I did that. I got straight zeroed in, focused. 24 hours a day was eBay and nothing else. It can hinder a lot of different things in your life. You got other important things in your life other than eBay. And if you don't, if you're single, maybe you're widowed, maybe you're whatever. I don't know your story, right? But there's still, even if you are widowed, it's good to be the best version of yourself. And everybody wants to get sales. Everybody talks all the time about, how do I get more sales? Be selfish. Start working on yourself. If you want to get better sales, if you want to get more consistent, if you want to get more disciplined, if you want to get more focused, if you want to scale your business to the next level, whatever that might be for you, it's going to be different for everybody else, then you got to be selfish. You have to be willing to become the 2.0 version of you to get to scale. Because wherever you are at in your personal, I like to call it your personal growth, right? Wherever you're at in your personal growth, that is only going to take you so far financially. Once that stuff starts changing, once your personal growth starts changing and you start becoming a better version of yourself and becoming a better, listen, I'm not telling you you're a freaking mess, okay? I'm not saying that by no means, but we all could be a little bit better in some aspect. It could be relationships. It could be health. It could be numerous amounts of other things, right? If you want to change your financial status, change your self-improvement. Work on your self-improvement. If you work on your self-improvement, the consistency, the discipline, your financial success, your feeling confident in what you do, all that comes right along with that. And if you're not willing to do any of them, look, I don't know what you believe in. You don't got to believe in God, right? You don't have to. I don't care. I don't care if you believe in a rock on the side of the road. I don't care. It doesn't make a difference, right? Because nobody's seen Jesus that I know of, right? So I don't know. I just believe in a power outside ourselves. Okay? So, whatever your higher power is, whoever, him, her, I don't care what it is. I don't care if it's a monkey in the rainforest. It doesn't matter to me, right? What matters is they're only going to give you what you can handle. So if you're breaking at $80,000 a year, $30,000 a year, $20,000 a year, and you're breaking and it's causing you chaos in your life, why would your higher power give you anything more? That you already can't handle what's going on. How are you gonna, the only way to be able to handle more is to become a better person, right? And look, I don't want anybody to say that, I don't want anybody to think neither that I think I was a bad person. Some of my priorities were out of line, right? I wasn't giving myself, I stopped self-growing, right? I stopped focusing on X amount of time a day to improve where I'm personally at. You know what I did? I got comfortable. I got comfortable living on $1,500, $2,500 a week. It is very simple to get comfortable in that lifestyle. Right? Depending where you're at. If you're living in California, then maybe you got to double that. I don't know. It does depend on your geometric area, wherever you're at, right? But it's really simple on eBay to get comfortable, right? You're knocking out $400, $500 a day in sales, $200 a day in sales. You can live on that. And it's easy to get comfortable there and not push yourself no further. And that's exactly what I did. So I was not being the best. I know deep down inside my soul what I'm capable of. And I know if I'm capable of it, so are all of you, right? And I was not giving it my all. And that's unfair to you guys. That's unfair to my family. That's unfair to everybody I come in contact with, right? And when I say giving it your all, I'm not, listen, don't think I'm saying work 18 hours a day and sleep freaking six. I'm not telling you to do that. Giving it your all. I was talking in a video the other day about being actually productive and not busy, right? I spent the past 2 years of my life being busy. Okay, I'm not saying that I didn't get some production done, but if I would have simmered down a little bit, focused a little bit more in those 2 years and been more productive, I'd be 10x where I'm at today. Does that make any sense? Can anybody relate with me? Be serious. Like, this is doing what you know you have to do to get you to where you got to go, right? That is becoming the best version of yourself, whatever it is. Maybe you drink no water. Like I said, it could be as simple as all I drink all day long is Mountain Dew. And eventually, you can do that shit all you want in your 20s, but eventually that's going to catch up to you. I'm telling you this now, right? I don't want to get off into health or anything like that, but I'm just using small examples. So in an example like that, you're gonna exclude one Mountain Dew a day and you're gonna add a 20-ounce bottle of water. These are little incremental changes that over a course period of time, you weaned yourself off the pop, you weaned yourself off the booze, you weaned yourself off whatever it was. I did that shit with cigarettes too. I went from two and a half packs a day sometimes for a lot of years. I can't tell you how many years. Okay, two and a half packs of smokes down to no smokes. That took me probably about 6 months to be able to do that. I gradually started doing it. Eventually, I got myself from two and a half packs of smokes down to two packs. From two packs down to one and a half packs. From one and a half packs to down to one pack. From one pack to three quarters of a pack. From three quarters of a pack to half pack. Half pack, couple cigarettes a day. And then finally, I said, this is just stupid. There's no sense in me smoking anymore. So I just quit, right? Now, I'll be doing the same thing with this too. Eventually, I will wean myself off this. And that's how it works for me, right? Alcohol and drugs, I had to quit cold turkey. I couldn't, well, maybe I'll just go snort a line in the AM and then maybe snort another line at 3 PM, right? And I'll be all right. No, I just had to cold quit. Certain things, you just got to quit, right? You can't. I don't know. I'm not trying to be a drug counselor or nothing, guys. I don't have them credentials, nor do I want anybody to try doing what I'm saying and then fail and then come back on me. But what I'm saying, self-development is the key to all your success on eBay. It really is. It doesn't matter. It don't matter what, I don't care if you want to get to $6 million a year, $20 million a year. It's going to take some self-improvement for sure. They say nothing changes until you change, right? And these are coming from multi-billionaires. Your financial situation, your relationships, your health, nothing changes until you change. And when the hardest part about at least mine was, about change throughout the course of my life. Drug addict, in and out of prison, in jail, failure after failure after failure, relationships, right? All that stuff in my life. The real root of the problem was, is I just didn't work on myself, right? I didn't know where to start. What do you mean I got to be a different person? Like, how do you do that? I had no direction. Well, it's one little step at a time, right? You wake up, you've been waking up at 7 o'clock in the morning for the past 5 years or whatever. Start waking up at 6. Start waking up at 6:30. Them little incremental improvements just advance your day by 30 minutes, an hour, right? It's the little thing, some little tiny things right there that makes, that just those little tiny things that makes all the difference. Yeah, have you ever been in a relationship and something's bothering you, but you don't want to say something because it's going to cause up a bunch of emotions, so you just swallow it down and tuck it down, right? Anybody attain to that? I've done that about 129 billion times in my throughout my adult and adolescent years and everything else, right? I didn't want to deal with the repercussions of bringing what's bothering me because I know it's going to upset the other person. I'm going to have to deal with those emotions. Has anybody ever had to do that? Anyways, I've done that a lot, and all I had to do is walk up to somebody in the right, and what that does is it causes you to explode after a while, and all I had to do is walk up to somebody with the right demeanor, maybe after the disagreement didn't go so well, you wait an hour or two, you walk off, you apologize, you say what was bothering you, you ask what you could do to make it better, and let's get on board together, and problem solved, instead of stuff, and 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 stuff, until a cat runs out in front of me in the little town of Hemlock, and I freak out on the cat, yelling at it like an idiot. That don't work neither. Self-improvement is your everything if you want to get to the next level. Continue watching, guys. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe. I think the video content within the next 6 months is going to take some turns you guys were not expecting. Definitely some turns I was not expecting. I am going to become the 2.0 of me. I've had it quite a few times in my life, and I'm going to get that back because I don't want to be selfish to you, the viewers, and I don't want to be selfish to myself anymore, right? I want to become the best version of me. I want you to become the best version of you. It's your boy, Flippinstoop. You guys have a rockin' rad day.